to Maitri's Kitchen. So today we are going to do another crispy crunchy snack, which is nothing but spring roll. For spring roll, these are the following items required. It goes very well for our evening snack along with coffee and tea. So the items required for doing spring rolls are the all-purpose flour. I've taken 2 cups. After that, we are going to add these vegetables. I have taken cabbage, green pepper, carrots, onion, 1 tablespoon soya sauce, 1 tablespoon chili sauce as per your taste, beans, chopped ginger, chopped garlic and the onions. So let us see the step-by-step process, how do we do it, along with salt, pepper and oil to fry. And so we have added 1 cup of all-purpose flour. I am adding another cup of all-purpose flour, which will be 200 grams overall. So with this, I am going to add the required amount of salt, followed with 1 tablespoon of oil. Then we need to mix this very well, like a chapati dough, in water little by little and keep it aside for 30 minutes. See friends, so the dough should be in this consistency, should be soft. It should not stick in your hand, it should be in this consistency. So I am going to apply just 1 tablespoon of oil so that it does not get dried, and close the lid and keep it aside for 30 minutes. So I have applied 1 spoon of oil and we are closing and keeping it aside for 30 minutes. We are going to do the inner stuffing ready for our spring onions. For that, I have taken 1 tablespoon of chopped garlic. I have just heated the kadai with 2 tablespoon of oil. I am adding the garlic. Followed with garlic, we are going to add the finely chopped ginger. As it is getting fried, I am going to add 2 small medium sized chopped onions. As the onion is getting tossed, we need to add the carrots. You need to cut in this shape the carrots, because for spring onions we should not chop it into pieces. It has to be in this shape. Every vegetable should be cut in this shape. You can see the carrots. This is how we need to cut the capsicum. It should be all in straight. And this is how we need to cut the beans, so that it gets cooked, because we are not going to cook the vegetable for longer time. It has to just be cooked for few seconds and we need to remove it, so that when you fry the spring onions, the vegetables inside will be crunchy, not soggy. So we should not cook for a longer time. So the vegetable should be taken care very importantly in the cutting stage, so that it gets very crunchy and nice. So now I am going to add 1 cup of bell pepper. You can add whichever color is available. So as the bell pepper is getting cooked, I am going to add the beans. I am adding everything 1 cup, so you can add as per the requirement. So let this also get cooked well. And at the final stage, we need to add the cabbage, because cabbage gets cooked very quickly. So we need to add the cabbage finally. Not to close the lid, nothing. Just fry it, toss it, and we need to off the stove. Should not get cooked well. That is the main point to be noted while doing the spring onions. So now at this stage, I am going to add 1 cup of cabbage. It looks so colorful. So now at this stage, I am going to add 2 tablespoons of red chili sauce. Followed with it, I am going to add 1/2 tablespoon of soya sauce. Be very careful while adding soya sauce, it will be very thick and salt will already be there in soya sauce. So while adding salt, please be cautious. We have kept aside for 30 minutes, so 30 minutes is over. So let us make small balls from the main dough, and I'll show you how to make the sheets. We have to make sheets for doing the spring roll. Then we need to do the stuffing. So let me roll it into small balls from the big one. So now we are gonna cut it into equally, so that the ball size is same. So now let us roll this into ball one by one. So you can take it one by one and roll it. You have to roll it into a puri size, not very big, to a normal puri size. I have taken three balls. I'll show you the first step how to do it. Then you can do the rest of the balls. So I've done it in the shape of a puri. So this size should be fine. So do it in the same way the other two balls. So friends, we have made it flattened like a puri. Now what? Take a plate. Keep this flattened puri size dough one by one into the plate and apply oil and all-purpose flour so that it does not stick into the other one. Though it sticks, it has to be removed well. So we will do one by one. Slight oil into it. Apply and keep it for all the flattened doughs. So let us apply for the next one also. We have applied the oil. Now I am going to dust it with little all-purpose flour every side. Just keep it all the sides dusted. The same way we need to do for other two flattened dough as well. So this is one. Then let me show the other one. Keep it aside. I kept it in another plate. So I am taking another dough. Just apply slight oil. So after applying oil, we need to dust it with all-purpose flour. So dust it across. Now what we are going to do is, we have already dusted and kept this. So this, we need to keep it on this. Same way, one more I am going to do it. Yes, we have applied oil and we have dusted with all-purpose flour. So I am keeping everything one above the other. So now you need to flatten this as much as possible to a thin sheets as much as possible. See friends, so one above the other we have kept it and make it as thin as possible. We have two sheets in this, you can make two or three at a time. Heated the tawa, keep it in sim. You can find the sheet, it has to be thin as much as possible. You can find my hand, just put it in this. It hardly takes 10 to 15 seconds. Once you find the bubbles, please remove it and keep it aside. See friends, so we have slightly made it to eat it. So you can remove it one by one sheet. You can find this here. See, it's come out so well. It's not at all sticking because we have applied enough oil. You can find it. So this is how we need to make the sheets. If you have the sheets left over, you can keep it in freezer, you can refrigerate it, and you can use it even for samosas. So this is how the sheet, we have taken our sheet. You can find the sheet, so transparent it is. You can see my fingers. So now we are going to cut into whichever shape we like. We are going to make a square shape right now. You can cut it using a pizza cutter or a scale, whichever is fine. Cut it into a square, all the four sides. So we have cut all the four sides. So we have got our sheet. So these corners you can make it small, small pieces and you can fry it as chips. You can fry it as chips, it will be nice. So in this, let us see how do we do the stuffing. And so now we are going to do our inner stuffing. So take amount of stuffing in the little in the corner towards the side, not in the center, so that you can fold it gently. 1 tablespoon of it. Kept it here. So roll it gently, should be like this. Roll once again, you will get a triangle kind of shape. At this stage, fold one from this side, one from this side, hold it tightly, roll it once again. Now I have taken the all purpose flour placed, that is a maida flour mixed with the water, to stick it around. Stick it all the three sides and fold this the other side. That's all. The spring roll inner stuffing is ready. You can find it. This is the spring roll. So now let us do all like that, and we need to deep fry it. See friends, so our spring roll is ready with all the stuffing. So we will do deep fry. So please see, our crunchy crispy spring roll has come out very well. You can see it is so crispy and so very crunchy. You can please try this recipe for your people. It's very easy to make, though it's time consuming. Please try this recipe. Watch my video, share my video, subscribe to my channel. Also, you can find the chips which we have kept here. The dough, whatever was available, the leftover dough, we did not waste it. We just made it as a crunchy chips. You can find it. It's so well, so very well it's come out. So please try this recipe. It's very yummy recipe. Since we have stuffed the vegetable, it's very good for health and nutritious. So watch my video, share my video, subscribe to my channel. We'll come up with another yummy recipe shortly. Happy cooking. Take care. Bye-bye.